Hello everyone. We made an auto NAT example in our previous lesson and we enabled our users and inside to access the internet by converting their private IPs to 44.34.0.1 IP of our firewall. But we may want our web or mail servers in our network to go to the internet with a static IP. For example, we can enable our server here to go to the internet with the IP of 44.34.0.100. All of our users here log out to the internet with an IP of 44.34.0.1. But we will ensure that our server here goes to the internet with the IP of 44.34.0.100. Now let's go to the firewall side and do our manual NAT configuration. When we come to the firewall side, let's come under the policy tab here. Here we choose NAT. Let's create a new rule by clicking the plus. Let's choose manual NAT from here and write web server NAT in its name. Here, our type will also be static. Our source interface is our gigabit 02 DMZ interface. Our source address is 10.1.0.100. Since we don't have an object here before, let's add a new object. I choose the host and type the IP address. I write its name as the web server LAN IP. Let's choose our object from here. We choose outside as the destination interface. In the source address section, we will add the IP address that we want our web server to go to the internet with. Let's add an object in it. Let's choose the host first, then write the IP we will log out from here. This server will go to the internet with the IP of 44.34.0.100. I write web server WAN IP in the name of the object. Let's choose our object. Here we will convert the IP of 10.1.0.100 to IP 44.34.0.100. I say OK. After adding our NAT rule, we need to create a rule for our web server. I'm coming to the access control part. Here, let's add a rule for the web server. Let our name be web server. I say allow, choose our source zone as DMZ and say OK. Our source address is web server LAN IP. Destination outside. Here I leave the application and URL part in any. I come to the log section and open our logs and say OK. With this rule we created, we allow traffic outside the web server in the DMZ zone. Let's deploy the changes we made and send them to our firewall. Let's check if our settings are loaded. Our settings have been loaded successfully. Let's open our web page and check if we can access the internet. When we come to our web server, let's check our IP first, then see if it can access the internet. Let's type pipconfig/all. You can see that our IP address is 10.1.0.100 and our gateway address is 10.1.0.254. Now let's open our web browser and run our test. Let's click on Yandex from here. We have internet access now. Let's open another page. Now let's go to our firewall and check our logs. When we come to the firewall side, we come to the event under the monitor tab. Here, when we click on connection, we can see our logs. Here you can see our web server logs out to the internet. From here, you can view the details by clicking view details. Here we can see that the source IP is 10.1.0.100 and this traffic matches the web server permission rule. We cannot see the NAT logs from here. We need to connect with the CLI to see the NAT logs. We can check our translated IPs from here. When we type shows late DMZ and press enter, we can see that the IP of 10.1.0.100 is translated to IP of 44.34.0.100 here. When you type shows late interface VLAN 11, you can see the translated IPs in VLAN 11 here. Since our NAT in VLAN 11 is dynamic and auto, here you can also see the port numbers at the end of the IP addresses. Here you can see that the request of the IP 172.16.1.100 with the port number 49.875 translates to 44.34.0.149.875. Since we are doing manual NAT here, we have made a one-to-one translation of 10.1.0.100 IP to 44.34.0.100 IP. You can see whether our NAT is working or not. By using the show's late interface command in the CLI, you can see the NAT logs related to the interface you want. That's all we have to say in this lesson. See you in our next lesson. Bye.